GYES. Hello friends, welcome to GYES. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on the channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, we also have started a test series for your prelims. As you know that your prelims is approaching and it is on 2nd June, and only you have now 40 to 45 days, and in these 45 days the best approach is to solve test series and to read the explanation of as many questions as possible. So for that purpose, like other institutes, we also have started our own series of our own test series for the purpose of prelims of UPSC to CSE 2019, in which we cover your 27 tests, that is 18 static tests and your 9 your current affair tests. So this is test number 2. So let's see what are the questions of it. First is, Zabti or Bandobast system during the reign of Akbar is related to. So this test is about the medieval India. So all the questions will be from your medieval India part. So first question is, Zabti or Bandobast system during the reign of Akbar is related to A. Land revenue system, B. Annexation of enemy territories, C. Mansabdari system, D. Welfare of travelers. So friends, here we only provide you the questions, and if you are willing to get the solutions as well as explanations, you will have to subscribe for our test series. And in case you wish to subscribe to the test series, you can contact us at this email ID or at this contact number, that is 8968426481. So let's see what is the second question. The second question is, who among the following were famous jurists of medieval India? A. Vijnaneshwara, B. Hemadri, C. Rajashekhara, D. Jimutvahana. So friends, you have to choose the correct answer. You can pause the video and can think about it and can mark your answer. And third question is, the Battle of Tarain is related to A. The Hindus princes of North India fighting against Muhammad Ghori, B. The battle between Marathas and Rajputs, C. Revolt in Gujarati kingdom against Mahmud of Ghazni, D. Land battles in Sindh between Muslim princes. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, bronze icons of Nataraja cast during the Chola period invariably show the deity with A. 8 hands, B. 6 hands, C. 4 hands, D. 2 hands. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following about the reign of Firoz Shah Tughlaq. First, he strictly followed the advice of ulemas in running the administration. Second, the Ikta system was made hereditary. Third, he was the first sultan to impose irrigation tax. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, under the Delhi Sultanate, Muktis or Walis were A. maintained law and order and collected land revenue, B. managed financial accounts and central treasury, C. led mercenary military units and special warfares, D. administered village assemblies. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, in his reign, the introduction of paying salaries in cash to the soldiers led to price regulations popularly called as market reforms. He was the first Sultan of Delhi who ordered for the measurement of land. His land revenue reforms provided a basis for the future reforms of Sher Shah and Akbar. So he is. So you have to choose the correct answer. A. Alauddin Khilji, B. Ghazi Malik, C. Balban, D. Iltutmish. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. Ahadis were those troopers who first offered their services singly, second did not attach themselves to any chief, third had the emperor as their immediate colonel, fourth attached themselves to the Mirzas. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, the member of Shivaji's Ashtapradhan who looked after foreign affairs was A. Peshwa, B. Sachiv, C. Pandit Rao, D. Sumant. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, a department called Diwan-e-Khairat was created under the reign of Firoz Shah Tughlaq to A. consolidate decentralized treasuries across the empire, B. take care of orphans and widows, C. address public grievances and complaints against officials, D. take care of religious tourists and travelers. So this is your 10th question. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, who of the following funded a new city on the south bank of a tributary to river Krishna and undertook to rule his new kingdom as the agent of deity to whom all the land south of the river Krishna was supposed to belong? So you have to choose the correct answer. A is Amoghvarsha, B Balala, C Harihara, D Prudra. So names are quite difficult to pronounce. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following First, the arrival of Babur into India led to the first introduction of gunpowder in the subcontinent, second introduction of arc and dome in region's architecture, third establishment of Timurid dynasty in the region. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, here in medieval India, the designations Mahatra and Patakila were used for A. military officers, B. village headmen, C. specialists in Vedic rituals, D. chiefs of craft guilds. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, which of the following statements about the administration under the Vijayanagar Empire is incorrect? A. The king enjoyed absolute authority in executive, judicial, and legislative matters. B. The king was the highest court of appeal. C. The succession to the throne was on the principle of merit. D. The king was assisted by a council of ministers in his day-to-day administration. 15th question is, the Batut Khana at Fatehpur Sikri was A. the mosque for the use of royal family. B. Akbar's private prayer chamber. C. the hall in which Akbar held discussions with scholars of various religions. D. the room in which the nobles belonging to different religions gathered to discuss religious affairs. Let's move to the next question. Next is, when Raja Vodayar founded the kingdom of Mysore, who was the ruler of the Vijayanagar Empire? A. Sadasiva, B. Tirumala, C. Rangattu, D. Venkatattu. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, Khalisa land under Delhi Sultanate was A. land assigned to officials as payment for their services, B. land under royal control from which revenues collected were spent for the maintenance of royal court, C. land assigned or granted to religious leaders or religious institutions, D. land granted to peasants in rural hinterlands for reducing poverty. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, the Mansabdari system was introduced by Akbar. What did Mansab of an officer imply in the system? A. salary of the officer. B. second, land granted to the officer. Third, number of soldiers maintained by the officer. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the Amara Naika system was a major political innovation of Vijayanagar Empire. The Amara Naikas were A. military commanders who were given territories to govern. B. chiefs of major municipalities. C. peasants who were made independent cultivators in order to encourage greater loyalty to the crown. D. independent spy advisors to the king. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, chronologically, which of these events happened after the invasion of Nadir Shah? A. First is, Ahmad Shah Abdali defeats the Marathas in third battle of Panipat. Second, the Diwani of Bengal transferred to the East India Company. Third, Humayun defeated by Sher Shah. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, the Zamindars held extensive personal lands, Milkiyat, in Mughal India. These lands could not be first cultivated for the private use of Zamindars, second sold or mortgaged at will by Zamindars. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, how did the dynasty of Nizam Sahis of Ahmednagar come to an end? A. Ahmednagar was annexed into Mughal Empire and Hussain Shah was given life imprisonment. B. Mughal troops destroyed Daulatabad fort and killed Nizam-ul-Mulk of Ahmednagar. C. Fateh Khan usurped the throne from Nizam-ul-Mulk. D. Malik Ambayar was defeated in a battle with Mughals in 1631 and the entire royal family was killed by Mughal troops. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, Narasimha Saluva ended the Sangama dynasty and seized the throne for himself and started Saluva dynasty. Second, Veera Narasimha deposed the last Saluva ruler and seized the throne for himself. Third, Veera Narasimha was succeeded by his brother Krishna Deva Raya. Fourth, Krishna Deva Raya was succeeded by his half brother Achyutya Raya. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, which of the following statements is correct about Francis Bernier? How Francis Bernier describes India? A. a bleak situation in comparison to developments in Europe. B. a land of high spiritual and scientific intelligence. C. a land of astounding beauty and natural resources. And your D is a highly affluent society integrated with the world. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, Lingayats do not practice funerary rites prescribed in Dharmashastras because they believed. First, funerary rites lead to environmental pollution. And your second is, after death, a devotee will not return to this world. C is, funerary rites are not needed as soul will take another birth soon. D is, it was a Brahminical practice and they opposed its domination. Next question is, according to Francis Bernier, some of the fundamental differences between Mughal India and Europe were first, lack of private property in land in Mughal India. Second, non-existence armies in Europe unlike in Mughal India. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following about Al-Biruni's work and stay in India. First, he translated Patanjali's work on grammar into Arabic. Second, he rejected Indian philosophy and spiritual ideas. Third, Al-Biruni disapproved of the existence of caste system in India. So you have to here also choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, with whose permission did the English set up their first factory in Surat? A. Akbar, B. Jahangir, C. Shah Jahan, D. Aurangzeb. So this, you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. As per Ibn Battuta's account of India, first, slaves were openly sold in markets and exchanged as gifts. Second, female slaves were employed by the Sultan to keep a watch on his nobles. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. A. Muhammad bin Tughlaq issued a new gold coin which was called dinar by Ibn Battuta. And R. is Muhammad bin Tughlaq wanted to issue token currency in gold coins to promote trade with West Asian and North African countries. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Khanakas and Silsilas are related to the tradition of A. Gibism, B. Bhatia, C. Sufism, D. Kahina. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following about Ashtapradhan. First, it was a council of eight ministers that administered the Maratha Empire. Second, it did not involve itself in military campaigns. Third is, no appointment to the body was made on a hereditary basis. Fourth is, its roles did not concern with dispensing justice on civil and criminal matters. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following about Abdul Hamid Lahori. First, he was the court historian of Shah Jahan. Second, he wrote the book Badshah Nama. Third, he was admitted to the Mansabdari system. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, with reference to the religious history of medieval India, the Sufi mystics were known to pursue which of the following practices? First, meditation and control of breath. Second, severe ascetic exercises in a lonely place. Third, recitation of holy songs to arouse the state of ecstasy in their audience. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Alam Khan, one of those who invited Babur to invade India, was A. An uncle of Ibrahim Lodi and pretender to the throne of Delhi. A cousin of Ibrahim Lodi who was ill-treated and expelled from the country. C. The father of Dilawar Khan, to whom cruel treatment was meted out by Ibrahim Lodi. D. Is a high official in Punjab province who was discontented with Ibrahim Lodi's treatment to his tribe. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, which of the following cannot be the reasons for the downfall of Hindu empires in India to the incoming Muslim rulers? First, the Hindu states were tied under a common federation, thus devoid of exercising power. Second, their military methods were out of date and inferior to those of Muslims. Let's move to the next question. Next question is, consider the following about land revenue collection in Mughal India. First, the land revenue was imposed without assessing the land. Second, payment was accepted only in kind and not in cash. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, after his accession to throne, why did Aurangzeb forbade the Kalma, that is holy messages, being inscribed on coins? So A. Coins could be trampled underfoot or be defiled in circulation. B. It increased the cost of producing coins. C. He wanted to separate the state from religious activities. D. Coins were to be made much thinner, and this negated the possibility of any description on the coin. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements about the travelers who visited India during the Mughal period. A. First is, Abdul Rang Samarkandi described the state as a land of poor but immense spiritual wealth. Second, Ibn Battuta provides detailed account of both Delhi and the Ultabath. Third, according to Frankius Bernier, there was no private property in land in Mughal India. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the authors of Tawarikh were usually ordinary villagers who took the help of learned men to compile their personal experiences for community benefit. Second is, Tawarikhs usually argued about maintaining social equality based on the intrinsic worth of human beings. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Aurang was a term used in medieval India for A. Tanti weavers of Bengal, B. Specialist block printers, C. Warehouse where goods were collected, D. Imported cotton prints. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following about the Sufis. First, they rejected outward religiosity and emphasized love and devotion to the God. Second, it rejected idol worship. Third, Sufis often rejected the elaborate rituals and codes of behavior demanded by Muslim religious scholars. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, Delhi first became the capital of a kingdom under the A. Tomra Rajputs, B. Chauhans, C. Delhi Walls, D. Tughlaq. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, a very interesting feature of medieval India was the sarais, which ringed cities and dotted a vast space of the Indian subcontinent. Sarais were A, voluntary bodies that took care of a city's land order; B, local private godowns which provided grain storage facility to adjoining farms. Next is places where that provided temporary accommodation to travelers and pilgrims. Next is the gahas that hosted religious and spiritual discussions. Sorry friends, let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following about a city in Madhya Pradesh which held strategic and recreational importance during the Mughal rule. First, its natural defense due to Malwa and Narmada encouraged consistent habitations by Parmara Rajputs, Afghans and Mughals. Second, it was the capital city of Ghori dynasty founded by Hoshang Shah. The above refers to. So you have to choose the correct answer. Next is, the Taj-e-Izzat invented by Humayun was first, a burqa for subject women; B, a royal headdress; C, a set of religious instructions targeting the moral decline in the empire; and your next is a code for conduct for female courtesans. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, who was Alma Prabhu? First, a social reformer of the Sangam age; B, a disciple of Saravajana who helped spread the Bhakti movement in Karnataka; C, a companion of Basavana who was instrumental in initiating the Veerashiva movement; D, the king of erstwhile Cholapur region. And you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, in medieval India, Zavita and Biswa were terms used in the context of A, agriculture productivity of fields; B, size of treasury; C, criminal justice system; D, none of the above. So you have to choose the correct answers out of this. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements with reference to Mughal state in medieval India. Assertion is, all legal matters were heard and decided only by the Mughal emperor. Reason is, all authority in the Mughal state flew from the emperor. So you have to choose that which of the following options is correct. So let's move on to the next question. Next question is 51st, and consider the following statements. First is, expansion of foreign trade in Mughal empire often involved the use of silver bullions as payment. Second, silver coins were discontinued in British India in view of growing deficit of the previous metal. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next 52nd question. Here it is, 5 is missed. So next question is, consider the following about Suleh Kul introduced by Akbar's regime. So you have to consider the following statements about this Suleh Kul. First is, the ideal of Suleh Kul was implemented through state policy. Second, Suleh Kul allowed all religions and schools of thought to flourish provided they don't impinge on state authority. So you have to choose the correct answer. So which of the above is correct? So you have to tell this. Next question is, consider the following statements. First is, the Portuguese travelers Domingo Pires and Fernão Nunes visited his empire. And second is, the South Indian mathematician Nilkantha Swamiji lived in his empire. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the Amara Naikas in Vijayanagara empire were royal spies who delivered information from one part of the empire to the another. B, Hindu Divans who were given the title of state landlords. C, scholars tasked with interpreting ancient religious texts. D, military commanders who were handed over territories to govern. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, in medieval India, Mukaddams were A, foreign travelers who were given imperial responsibilities. B, qazis who issued decree on behalf of the emperor. C, caretakers of the luxury estates of royal family in the different parts of the empire. D, headmen of village. You have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Sikdar officials in Mughal India were mainly responsible for A, regulating water storage and availability in the provinces; B, maintaining law and order; C, implementing fatwas issued by the emperor; D, supervising work of welfare department. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, some sources of 17th century refer to two terms, Khudkhasta and Pahikhasta. So they refer to, first, the types of absentee landlordism in rural pragnas; second, land grants given by Amin to notable individuals. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements in the context of medieval India and their correct matches. First, Jasmani system, art and craft production. Second, Malhazadas, cattle traders. Third, Milkiyat, private land of Zamidar. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following with reference to Mughal India. First, the Mughal state fixed land revenue on the basis of quality and extent of the land. एंड योर सेकंड इज मुगल ऑफिशियल्स वर अलाउड टू कलेक्ट लैंड रेवेन्यू इन बोथ कैश एंड काइंड सो दैट स्टेट रेवेन्यू कुड बी मैक्सिमाइज सो यू हैव टू चूज द करेक्ट आंसर लेट्स मूव टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नेक्स्ट इज इन द 18th सेंचुरी अ नंबर ऑफ एस्ट्रोनॉमिकल स्ट्रक्चर्स वर बिल्ट बाय जयसिंह टू इन वेस्ट सेंट्रल इंडिया दीज आर टूडे नोन बाय द कॉमन नेम ऑफ ए यंत्र वेदशाला वी समरकंद ऑब्जर्वेटरी सी घराध्याया डी जंतर मंतर Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following with reference to the views of French traveler Bernier about India. First, he wrote that Sanskrit was closest to European languages and sponsored several works of intertranslation of texts. Second, he denounced the system of crown ownership of land. Third, he was associated with Mughal court as an economic and social advisor. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is the Dharshala system of 16th century is most closely associated with. A. Land revenue system, B. Criminal justice system, C. Military organization, D. Construction of travelers' rise or guest houses. Let's move on to the next question. Next is consider the following about Ibn Battuta's account of India. First, the highways were safe from robbery and other crimes. Second, coconut fiber found in India was so strong that it was used for making ropes which pulled ships. Third, Indian textiles such as fine muslins were in great demand in Asian markets. Fourth, horses and human runners were often used to dispatch goods required at short notice. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following with reference to the forest society and tribes in Mughal India. First, the forest tribes often supplied elephants to the state as a tribute. Second, the forest provided gum, lac, which was a major export item overseas from India. Third, the state banned private commercial agriculture in forest regions. To preserve the pristine ecology. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is Sufi silsilas became a major tradition in medieval India. The term silsila implies A. family of guest houses for spiritual debates. B. spiritual genealogy linking the master to the disciples. C. is a method of chanting leading to communion with God. Next is a distinct way of Sufi poetry that later developed as a mature classical style. Let's move on to the next question. Next is consider the following statements about important officials in Mughal Empire and their responsibilities. First, Fotedar Treasurer. Second is Diwan-e-Risalat Army Commander. And third is Karkoon's Engineering Structures. Fourth is Diwan-e-Insha Minister for Communication. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is consider the following statements with reference to the developments in medieval India. First is a personal astronomical observatory was built by Humayun on the banks of Yamuna River. Second is the metal cylinder rockets were often used in wars waged by some of the Mughal rulers. Third, shampoo, bath techniques and related chemicals were introduced in Mughal India from Europe. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is consider the following about rural institutions in medieval India. First, the village panchayats represented only the most dominant caste in the village. Second, the village headman was to be compulsorily nominated by the subedar who headed the pragnas. Third is the panchayat could drive its funds from the contributions made by community residents to a common financial pool. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is consider the following about Vijayanagara Empire. First is the Chinese porcelains were banned within the empire by the ruler. Second is the arrangements were made to store rainwater and conduct it to the city. Third is the fortifications around the empire enclosed agricultural tracts. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following about Alvars and Nayanars. First, they found the caste system valid and based on practical lines. Second, women devotees were not allowed within the Sangha. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is here, who was the last ruler of Tughlaq dynasty of Delhi Sultanate? A. Firoz Shah Tughlaq and your B is Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq Shah II. C is Nasiruddin Mahmud. D is Nasrat Shah. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is consider the following statements about Sikh gurus. First, Banda Bahadur was appointed as the military leader by the Sikhs by Guru Tegh Bahadur. Second, Guru Arjan Dev became the first Sikh guru after Guru Ram Das. Third, Guru Arjan Dev gave to Sikhs their own script, that is Gurmukhi. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is among the following who was not a proponent of Bhakti cult. A. Nagarjuna, B. Tukaram, C. Tyagaraja, D. Vallabhacharya. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Is Battle of Dharmat was fought between A. Muhammad Ghori and Jaichand, B. Babar and Afghans, C. Aurangzeb and Dara Shikoh, D. Ahmad Shah Durrani and Marathas. Next question is, which of the following is correct with reference to religious views of Akbar? First, he believed in a self-conceived eclectic form of divine worship focused on light and sun instead of orthodox religious views. Second is, he believed that any discussion on religious matters is futile as religion belongs exclusively to the personal sphere. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, Al-Biruni is regarded as one of the greatest scholars of medieval Islamic era. In 1017, he traveled to the Indian subcontinent and authored Kitab al-Hind. History of India considered the following statements about Al-Biruni's account of India. First, he called the Upanishads and Vedas as pseudo-philosophy. Second, he considered Indian astronomy as rudimentary and unscientific. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, Akhlaq-e-Nasiri is a part of overall code of conduct of Akbar's Sulaykal religion, B. Persian book in philosophical ethics written by Al-Tusi, C. a Sufi practice of extreme asceticism followed by penance, D. is a group of scholars in Akbar's Ibadat Khana who wrote religious codes. So let's move to the next question. Next is, the official Amin in Mughal India was responsible for A. ensuring that imperial regulations were carried out in the provinces, B. ensuring external security and diplomatic negotiations for peace, and next is supervising the work of all welfare departments at the center, D. is extracting dues from defaulters. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following factors were responsible for the crisis in Mughal Empire towards the end of the 17th century? First is depletion of military and financial resources in wars with Deccan during Aurangzeb's tenure. Second is growing power of Mansabdars, third peasant and Zamindari rebellions. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, in 18th century India, what was the practice of Ijardari? A. Using revenue farmers for the collection of state revenue, B. Association of merchants and bankers in management of the central Mughal treasury, and your next is auctioning of the right to collect taxes by the British to the highest bidders, D. is military positions in Mughal state being given on the basis of patronage. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, Bhakt Tukaram was a contemporary of which Mughal emperor? A. Babur, B. Akbar, C. Jahangir, D. Aurangzeb. So let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following works was entitled Razm Nama by its Persian translators? A. Atharvaved, B. Leelavati, C. Mahabharata, D. Ramayana. And let's move to the next question. Next is, Al-Biruni was the contemporary of A. Balban, D. Mahmud Ghazni, and your C is Muhammad Ghori, and your D is Qutbuddin Aibak. Next question is, 84th, who among the following was the Portuguese governor in India? Sorry, second Portuguese governor. A. Vasco da Gama, B. Francisco de Almeida, and C. is Alfonso de Albuquerque, and D. is Francisco Xavier. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, whose permission was solicited by Albuquerque, the Portuguese governor, to build a fort at Bhatkal? A. Achutya Raya, B. Krishna Deva Raya, C. Saluva Narasimha, D. Vira Narasimha. And let's move on to the next question. Next is, with reference to the medieval Indian rulers, which one of the following statements is correct? A. Alauddin Khilji first set up a separate Aris department. B. Balban introduced a branding of horses in his military. C. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was succeeded by his uncle to the military. D. is Firoz Shah Tughlaq set up a separate department of slaves. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, which of the following pairs is correctly matched? A is Diwane Bandgani Tughlaq, B is Diwane Mustakhras Balban, C Diwane Kohi Alauddin Khilji, and Diwane Arz Muhammad Tughlaq. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, match list 1 and list 2 and select the correct answer using the codes given below the list. Ikta, Zagir, Amaram, and your Moksa. And here it is Marathas, Delhi Sultans, 3rd Mughals, and 4th Vijayanagara. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, Mongols under Chinggis Khan invaded India during the reign of A. Balban, B. Firoz Tughlaq, C. Iltutmish, D. Muhammad bin Tughlaq. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, the system of price controls was an important component of Alauddin's Khilji's market reforms. Why were price controls placed? So you have to choose here why they were placed at the first place. It was the duty of a welfare state, B. to reduce the remuneration paid to the large army, C. gain more competitiveness in grain trade with neighboring states, destabilizing markets from unnecessary price inflations by producers. Let's move to the next question. Next is, during the time of Akbar, for even 10 cavalrymen, the Mansabdars had to maintain 20 horses. Next is, horses had to be rested while on march and replacements were necessary in times of war. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the medieval Indian writer who refers to the discovery of America is A. Malik Muhammad Jaisi, B. Amir Khusro, C. Rashid Khan, D. Abul Faisal. Let's move to the next question. Next is, you have to match some lists, that is list 1 and list 2. So list 1 is the name of the Bhakti saints, and list 2 is the professions of these people. A. Namdev, B. Kabir, C. Ravidas, D. Sena, and the professions are given are barber, weaver, tailor and cobbler. And let's move on to the next question. Next is, which one of the following Muslim rulers was hailed as a Jagat Guru by his Muslim subject because of his belief in secularism? A. Hussain Shah, B. Zainuluddin, C. Ibrahim Adil Shah, D. Mahmud II. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, reign of Krishna Deva of Vijayanagara. Second is construction of Qutub Minar. Third, arrival of Portuguese in India. Fourth, death of Firoz Tughlaq. So you have to arrange them in proper order. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, the king was freed from his people and they were from their king. On whose death did Badami comment this? A. Balban, B. Alauddin Khilji, C. Muhammad bin Tughlaq, D. Firoz Shah Tughlaq. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the Sur Empire may be considered in many ways as a continuation and culmination of Delhi Sultanate. Which of the following were some of the reforms introduced by Sher Shah? First, he repealed the land revenue system to promote a welfare state. Second, he restored the old imperial Grand Trunk Road from the river Indus in the west to Sunargaon in Bengal. Third, customs duties were abolished on goods to promote trade and commerce. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, what was the reason behind Muhammad bin Tughlaq's transfer of capital from Delhi to Daulatabad? First, he wanted to keep Daulatabad safe from Greek invasion. Second, Delhi held a referendum which resulted in transfer of capital to Daulatabad. Third, Daulatabad was situated very close to the northern frontiers of his empire, which allowed better control. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, the Raj Tarangani by Kalhan is A. Sanskrit account of various monarchies of Kashmir, B. Genealogy of major kingdoms in southern India, C. Accounts of Deccan wars and invasions by foreigners, D. Spiritual guide to the kingdoms of medieval India. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question and the last question of the day. The last question is, first battle of Panipat is regarded as one of the most decisive battles of Indian history. Which are the reasons behind it? First, it reinvigorated Lodi's power and reduced the influence of Babur, especially in Delhi and Agra. Second, it led to an economic unification of eastern southern India and southeastern India. So you have to choose the correct answer. So these are the friends, the questions of test number 2 of medieval India. So you can see the quality of questions. We are not just making questions from just simple facts. So here you are complete conceptual as well as factual analogies tested. And also we are including the questions from previous year papers. So in this manner you can prepare for your exam comprehensively. So in case you wish to join us, to join our test series, you can email us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at this number, that is 8968426481. So only those students who have subscribed to a test series, only they, the solutions and explanations of the tests will be shared with only those students. So thank you friends, have a very nice day. If you like this video, then please do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon. So thank you friends, have a very nice day.